hear about this? I used data from the Allen Institute. You might be familiar with them. They have a massive open data set. So I looked at these six areas.
I'm interested in studying how we perceive the world around us, especially in the visual cortex.
The minimum number we went with was 10.
My name is Kathleen Esfahany. I'm a senior at Ward Melville High School.
My name is Ilmenin Park. I'm an assistant professor at Stony Brook University. CATIB Lab is an acronym for Computational and Theoretical Neural Information Processing.
I joined CATNIP through the Simon Summer Research Program at Stony Brook. It's a program that allows high school students to try original research projects. My project was a population decoding analysis of six mouse visual areas. I looked at differences in how they encode information. I used the calcium imaging data that the Allen Brain Observatory recorded.
There are many different organizations of the visual system, and we wanted to find out different areas of the brain and also the different depths and cell types. Is there a reason that we have such a structure?
We ended up finding that different populations across depths and visual areas and cell types encode information differently. And through looking at more individual neuron analysis, we were able to find that different areas also have synergy or redundancy relative to others.
The Allen Brain Observatory data really provides a platform so that people can compare different methods and approaches on the same data set, and this data set is very rich.
I was really amazed by the size of the data set.
The main advantage is really that it's big.
The Allen Institute data offers you an unbelievable number of avenues to explore. When I go to college next year, I hope to do more projects with the Allen Institute data and also look at new brain areas outside of the visual cortex and see how everything ties together.
I'm always very impressed by how much she can absorb and how much she grew. What makes my life really happy is when I see people grow and doing science. And if we have many, many, many students like Kathleen, I think the future of the field is very bright. And yeah, we'll make good science.